Alrighty, welcome to another Vintage Cube Draft here on ChannelFireball.com. By the way, everything on Channel Fireball is free now. Tons of awesome strategy articles that you should definitely check out by the likes of Reed Duke, Andrea Mengucci, and on occasion, myself. As for this pack, what are we slamming? There's a Memory Lapse, there's a Misty Rainforest, a Dak Faden, a Gristlebrand, a Time Warp, I guess. I'm just going to take Misty Rainforest. I think Fetchlands, they make the world go round. And, oh man, starting Fetchland into Fetchland, the dream? I think I'm going to take Arid Mesa here and see if we can draft a, I don't know, it doesn't have to be a five-color deck, but just starting with two Fetchlands, even ones that don't overlap, I just think it's better than taking mid-tier playables that ultimately are replaceable. All right, so here, I mean, Chromox isn't a bad pick either. So one of the things I really like to do in Cube is the deck that is a lot of powerful three and four drops with fetch lands, one drop accelerators, stuff like Chromox. So you're casting your like Oko or Tireless Tracker sort of cards on turn two, ideally. And I think Chromox fits into that. Plus, the next best card, there's like Colonnade, Liliana, Spellbomb, Dressdown. These are all fine, but I think Chromox is better. And then here, there's a Grist the Hunger Tide. That's exactly the kind of card I was talking about. There's also an Inquisition of Kozilek, but I think given that I have Chromox and two fetches, I'm just going to take the more powerful card, which is the Grist. Over Grist, there's a Chariot and a Ballista, but I really like a Grist the Hunger Tide. I guess I'll put it here because it's like a creature, you see. So with this start, there's a lot of directions we can go, but we can kind of just read the packs, take fixing, and then supplement that with the best cards that we see. So my strategy with these five-color decks, which, again, that's the direction we're trending, though we aren't guaranteed to go there, is spend your early picks on either fetch lands or duels, you know, fixing, acceleration, like, obviously, actual moxes, but also stuff like Birds or Ignoble Hierarch. And then things like Oko or Grist are high picks, but you can fill out the rest of the playables later. Cards like Vindicate or Terra Sunder, like, you get those with four cards in the pack because you can just play all of them. So it opens up the possibilities such that you can spend your early picks on fixing and busted cards and fill out the kind of middle of the deck with just cards you get later. Ooh, interesting. There's a Skullclamp here. I do like Snuff Out and I like Uro with all these fetches, but Grist Skullclamp is nice and Skullclamp is nice with Mana Elves. So this actually looks like a really good spot to take a Skullclamp. And here, well, as much as I love LED, this is not an LED deck so much. I don't really like taking Ramunap without Waste or Strip Mine. There's Raugrin Triumph, which is nice because it turns Misty into a four-color land, Arid Mesa into a three-color land. Stomping Ground also helps with both. There's also Daze and Duress. I'm kind of interested in Duress. Duress is a good way to convert the cards from Skullclamp into action that disrupts your opponent. And because of Grist, I'm already going to be playing some black sources, so I think Duress is solid here. Whew. All right, well, this is kind of what I'm talking about. There's a Solitude here, and I'm just going to take it. Like, yeah, I don't have the support for it yet, but Solitude is a busted card. Like, Solitude is one of the better cards in the cube. Getting one seventh pick is pretty crazy, and as much as I do like Tishana's Tidebinder, Solitude is definitely the pick here. Ooh, and then we can follow up with a Leyline Binding. Yeah, this is going well, though. Oh, this is actually close. Samwise the Stouthearted is also awesome. Samwise can go just pick up a Fetchland on two, which is great. Skullclamp works with Samwise in multiple ways. You can also evoke Solitude, then Samwise it back to your hand. All right, the Skullclamp stuff makes me want Samwise. And then here, I think I'm supposed to take Xander's Lounge because it works with both fetches. And I think that's going to be better than Tundra. You want some amount of tri-lands, and that's a pretty nice tri-land to pick up. I think I will take Adeline here. I don't really want Prismatic Omen. I don't like Prismatic Omen. I don't think you should play it. I don't know that I'm going to play Adeline, but I did pick up three good white cards. It's possible white's really open and maybe we're not going to play all five colors. Maybe we should have just taken Tundra, but I don't know. We'll see. Well, you know, all that being said about these five color decks, I've gotten past four pretty high pick. Like Solitude's first pickable, Skyclave and Adeline are like, I would say third through fifth pickable. Samwise is pretty good. Now there's a Glimmerlens, though the Renegade Rallier looks okay. I actually think it's going to be Glimmerlens. Are we just audibling into Mono White? Just like, all right, I take these duels away. Wow, I really wish I took Tundra now. Oh, Winds of Abandon's a fine card too. This is such a weird draft, but you know, if it's open, it's open. And this is about as open as it gets. I think the lounge could still help. It depends on where we end up. But we just got six good white cards, seven good white cards. I do like Once Upon a Time too, but I've never audibled like quite like this, where basically the last half of the pack were seven good white cards out of eight cards. I took a Xander's Lounge in between. Yeah, I mean, that's a direction to go for sure. And a last pick paradoxical outcome that I'm not going to play. And then a first pick. Well, there's Council's Judgment and Figure of Destiny. There's also Stoneforge Mystic, which can go get Skullclamp. And there's Mana Leak. And there's Hallowed Fountain. And I guess Shadow Spear. I think I'm going to take Stoneforge and probably wield my choice of Council's Judgment Figure, honestly. But we'll see. There's also Hallowed Fountain and Mana Leak that could be potential. But yeah, Stoneforge works with Skullclamp. And if I pick up one of the good equipments, it'll be nice too. All right, this pack is a lot less enticing. Wandering Emperor is good. I don't really like Palantir too much in this style of deck. Just the curve is a little low. I mean, it's okay. I'd still play it. Scrubland is good. Bloodstained Mire is obviously fine. But I think I just take Wandering Emperor. I think this is where we're at. Now I can just take... Oh, I do like Lightning Bolt. Maybe I take Lightning Bolt and try to wheel Elite Spellbinder or Porcelain Legionnaire. Because I have Arid Mesa. And I can help splash Bolt. I'm kind of figuring I'm not playing Grist and Duress. But... we'll see on those. I mean, the Tundra wouldn't even matter that much. I don't have any blue cards I want to play. Yeah, Lightning Bolt's a pretty busted card. Let's just take that. And then now Palace Jailer. I do like Path, but I already just took Bolt. I have Winds. I have Solitude, Skyclave. Palace Jailer is just a great four-mana play. And we're drafting kind of a nice mono-white deck here, maybe splashing this Bolt. The Xander's Lounge I could also put in, potentially, depending on where I end up. But, you know what? This is drafting. This is being good at draft. I'm not claiming I'm good at draft. I think it's just like unarguable that I am. But this is an example of pivoting really hard, which doesn't happen in very many drafts. But I think the reward is most definitely worth it here. Ooh, I love me a Novice Inspector. Gut is also pretty sick, but I think I just take Smuggler's Copter. This looks like a pretty good Copter deck. And then Novice Inspector, Lion Sash, and maybe Gut could all potentially come back. But I think I like Copter here. This pack's a little bit less enticing. Oh, my five-color deck would have loved a Birds and a Territorial Kavu. There is Timeless Dragon. There's also Badlands. And the reason Badlands is a little bit interesting is Duress is a strong card. I have it in the sideboard here. If I could splash Duress, again, it's still really good in these kinds of decks. I think Portable Hole and Timeless Dragon are pretty replaceable, so I'm just going to take the Badlands just in case. Here, I'll just take Esper Sentinel or Intrepid Adversary. They're both pretty good. I think Skullclamp is great. I mean, they're great with both. I think I'm going to take Esper Sentinel just to have a one drop. And one, let's see, one, two, three, four, five. I could get a last pick Intrepid Adversary, though I don't think that's going to happen. I think it's pretty clear I'm the only person drafting White Weenie. Wow, now I could take Othari. I guess this red splash looks like it could work out here. Othari's great. Just five mana, 3/3 flying, lifelink, haste. Attacks alongside a 2/2, and the next turn 3 2/2s, and so on and so forth. And I have some interaction. I would like to get the Duress in if possible. I'm not gonna like compromise too much on the mana, but if you can, I mean, it's good. And look, I told you, Council's Judgment and Figure are both still here. I think I'm just gonna take Figure. I feel like with Palace Jailer, Solitude, Skyclave, Lightning Bolt, Winds of Abandon, I'm doing pretty well on removal, and having more one drops is pretty important, especially when you've got a Skullclamp here. I would love to pick up, I guess the Cauldra equipment is not in Cauldra Complete. I don't think is in the Magic Online queue, but I do have a Glimmer Lens and a Skullclamp, so my Stoneforge is good no matter what here. Ooh, and Scrubland came back. This is perfect. This Duress splash is now, I would say, fairly easy to justify. Between Spadland, Scrubland, and Arid Mesa, playing like two red cards and two black cards in my mono white deck seems totally doable. All right, well, Elite Spellbinder didn't come back, but Porcelain Legionnaire did, and I'm happy enough with that, so no complaints here. And I think I'm probably going to wheel another card or two, which means going into pack three, we're doing great. Here, I don't really want Deserted Beach. I'll take Arc Trail, and that's a little bit weaker. It's more of a sideboard. Oh, Novice Inspector came back. Sorry, Lion Sash. I love Novice Inspector. With Smuggler's Copter and even Skullclamp, like, it's just such a good combo. Lion Sash is a sideboard card against Reanimate. I don't really like main decking it, though I can get it with Stoneforge, which is kind of nice. But Getting that Novice Inspector back was sweet. Oh, and Timeless Dragon came back, which is currently a black source as well, thanks to Scrubland. I would really like to find a Plateau or Sacred Foundry, which I don't think we've seen yet. That would be a nice pickup, but even then, right now, I'm getting pretty close to having enough playables here. And I got the last pick Intrepid Adversary. If you're wondering whether this is the right deck to be in, it is assuredly so. A disappointing first pick, but, you know, there's not that much I can open. I'm just going to take Windswept Teeth. That's totally fine. It just adds another black source. Doesn't add a white source yet, but or a red source, rather. But it has another black source, which just makes the mana even better. And honestly, with double fetches, Scrubland and Badlands, and Timeless Dragon, I would feel comfortable taking another black card if I saw one that I wanted. This pack... no white card I really want. I don't care about Touch the Spear. I'll just take another fetch land. Taking a Flooded Strand here. I also have a Xander's Lounge, which at some point could do something if I cared to. But I think, yeah, Flooded Strand has to be better than Scalding Tarn here. So Scalding Tarn can get Badlands, but it can't get Scrubland anyway. So I'll just take another white fetch. And, you know, the way this draft has gone, I could just see a fourth or fifth pick great white card. And it wouldn't be that surprising. So... the fact that my first two picks were fetch lands means I'm not going to have any power in the deck, but this is the kind of deck that can win very easily without it. Oh, or you get a third pick Orcish Bowmasters. Yeah, I'm slamming that, and taking all these fetch lands has worked out perfectly for that. Oh, so good with Skull Clamp. It's just a great card. Punishes people for drawing cards, which they love doing in Cube. Right now, we're at 17 land and a Mox and a Timeless Dragon, I suppose, so... I could use one or two more playables, which I'm obviously trivially going to get. The question is, is there anything that I'm looking to cut here? I kind of like all the cards I have in, so I like where this deck's going. All right, this pack has a Fury, which is a busted card. I guess I have three red cards, Othari, Bolt, and Figure. I think I'm just going to take Mother of Runes, though. Mother of Runes is excellent. This deck has plenty of removal. I'm not worried about being too slow, which Fury helps with. And Shodan of the Scalds I would gladly take if it came back, but I'm going to take Mother of Runes here. I don't need to take Verdant Catacombs, even though it is a red-black-white land. I feel like at this point taking Mother of Runes is good, because Mother of Runes is kind of a busted card. All right, and here... see, here's kind of a miss, because there's a Wooded Foothills, which is a red-black land, but I don't really want to play, like, basic mountain in my deck if I can avoid it. Really, like, a red-white land is what I want. There's Seasoned Hallowblade, but I don't even think that's better than any of my other cards. I think I'm just going to take Soul God Lantern in case I do play against Reanimator. Just have like a very strong sideboard card there. Timeless Dragon I'll also cut for now. Maybe I'll end up playing it, but I kind of don't want to. Okay, so this pack has a Fiery Confluence, but I don't really want a double red card in my deck. Temple Garden does nothing. Vindicate I could definitely cast if I wanted to. It's okay, but... Thraben Inspector, though. Have you considered Thraben Inspector? I have, and Thraben Inspector is what I want. Ooh, Mana Tithe. There's also Steel Seraph. Steel Seraph is pretty strong. I could use another like kind of hard-hitting card. Right now, I'd have to cut a card to play it. That's fine. I'll find something to cut. And, hey, you know what? Savai Triumph is the trial land of my colors. This is 38th picks, the last opportunity, and that means at least all the lands get all my colors if I need them to. Seasoned Pyro would be nice. I guess I technically, now that I picked up Savai Triumph, have like five red sources without playing any mountains, but I think I'll just take the Relic Warder for the sideboard. I'm already cutting a card as is. So right now, and then Touch the Spirit Realm is a good combo with Solitude, and blinking like Jailer or something can be good. I have to cut a couple cards here. My one drops are nice. My two drops are nice. I guess Porcelain Legionnaire is maybe the worst. Oh man, Giver of Runes came back. Excellent. Excellent, excellent. This deck is a banger. I could cut Winds of Abandon or Touch the Spirit Realm if I wanted to. Ooh, Shodan of the Scalds versus Elspeth. This deck has such a low curve, it actually seems like this could be a better showdown deck. Now we're at 14 lands. Now we gotta cut three. We keep getting good cards. We have to cut some of them. Let's see. Don't want to cut any of the ones. Sure, I'll take the Hallowblade, whatever. Yeah, I already cut the Porcelain Legionnaire too. Oof, okay. I could cut the Duress and maybe just side it in. This deck does seem like it's pretty solid. I could cut... no, can't cut Glimmerlands. I have a Stoneforge Mystic. And Glimmerlands is good with this many one-drops. I don't really want to cut Lightning Bolt. I could cut Winds of Abandon, I suppose. Now we're playing 16 land, 15 in a Chrome box. We're getting closer. Like all my cards are so good. It's really just kind of a blessing and a curse, you know? I suppose I could cut one of the Thraben Inspectors. Huh, Mutavault? I actually think this deck could afford Mutavault despite being three colors. Just I have three fetch lands, a tri-land, and two duels. I mean, it doesn't really get too much better than that. Yeah, I could cut one or I could just play 16 land because I have, what's it, 6, 10, 13 cards that cost one or two mana, or 13 creatures that cost one or two mana plus some spells, and only a couple of cards that are more expensive plus two Thraben Inspectors. All right, I think we got a deck here. Let's see. Add basic lands. I don't think I need any swamps or mountains, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 black sources. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 red sources. I guess I could lead like, I could add like one mountain. Because right now, let's say I go to 16 lands, I'm adding 8 lands. That's 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 white. I could go to 14 white. That's probably fine. They want 6, 1. I think I want 7, 1. All right. Yeah, this deck actually came out really well. I think this is a very good white weenie deck, especially for not opening any like really busted cards. I think this deck can compete. And I've got a really good sideboard too with Duress, Winds of Abandon, Leon, Relic Warder, Soul Guide Lantern, some pretty good hateful cards. Even Arctralia, these are all very strong sideboard cards. And Orcish Bowmasters helps, having the double Mother Runes, all the one drops. If this deck leads on land mocks to one drops, it's just going to be disgusting. And Skull Clamp looks pretty good here too, plus good high end. So can't wait to see how this does. This one's good. Let's get to our matches. Alrighty, time for round one. Let's see if this late pivot is going to pay off. And, well, this hand is pretty good. So it's actually kind of interesting what you turn one, because Giver of Runes has an activated ability, so you kind of want to get that into play to have the shields up. On the other hand, turn one Esper Sentinel messes up turn one cantrips, moxes, any of those things, discard spells. I think I'm going to lead with Esper Sentinel, because if I go turn one Esper Sentinel and they have a removal spell, then I still draw a card. And I think that makes up for the fact that I'll get Giver Protection one turn later. We'll see if they go, you know. I guess if they play like a Mana Dork on one and then a Burn spell on two, I'll have regretted this. But if I played turn one Giver, they also probably could have just played the turn one removal. So I like leading on Esper Sentinel here. If I could draw a Chrome Mox, I could go real deep. All right, turn two Adeline would be nice. Well, drawing a 4-drop isn't ideal. Would like to hit a land here, just a Plains. Plains lets me go Steel Seraph or Adeline, probably Adeline. And let's hope this isn't a removal spell. Once upon a time, having to pay one for Esper Sentinel. That's pretty good, actually. I don't mind. All right, let's see what they're going to once upon a time into here. They get their option of any creature or land. The loading screen of magic is the way this card was once described. Nurturing Peatland? Okay, do you have a mana dork? Or a removal spell? Cut down on the Esper Sentinel. Okay. Oh, the Esper Sentinel, not the Giver of Runes. All right. Land. No, I guess that's okay, but I really need to draw a land here. If I draw a land, I can start bashing pretty fast. And I have a Giver of Runes, so I feel pretty good about protect, and a Selfless Spirit. In fact, all my creatures offer some good protection. Not sure what we're playing against, besides obviously some sort of Sultai Brew. Oko, Thief of Crowns. Okay. All right, if I draw a land here, I actually still like my shot. If I don't, it's going to be tough. Well, I guess I drew a 2-drop. All right, I'll attack Oko for 2. I think I want to leave Giver of Runes up still. Funnily enough, I can't protect the Smuggler's Copter because I can't crew it and use Giver of Runes with just the Giver untapped. But if they want to elk my Smuggler's Copter, I'm okay with that too. I guess it plays into It would play into Toxic Deluge. Elk my copter, then Deluge. That'd be sick. All right, they elked their food, but I have a bunch of flyers, so I'm not that worried. And a Delighted Halfling. Okay. And Revoker. Oh, that's annoying. That's going to name Copter. I still think I'm okay if I draw a land. It's getting to be less okay, obviously, as time goes on. But, you know. Okay, I'll take three. I guess I could have crewed the Copter in response to Revoker, maybe. Okay, there's a land. And definitely want to go Adeline here. Because I want to be able to give the Adeline flying next turn. Attack Oko. Make a 1-1. That doesn't matter because it's just going to get blocked by Delighted Halfling. Oko goes down to 3. But Adeline blocks all the attackers. And I have Giver plus Adeline, which is nice. And then next turn, Steel Seraph can make Adeline fly, which will presumably kill Oko. And I'm only one mana away from Wandering Emperor and getting on the road there to Authari as well. 3 mana. They can prompt my use of Giver with Oko. I don't think I care about Graveyard Trespasser pretty much at all. Given that I'm not really going to take damage this turn, most likely. But yeah, they can basically force me to use Giver by using Oko on like Adeline, for example. But they're just going to make a food. And, oh, one more play too. A legend even. Gix, okay. Well, can't attack here. Adeline has Vigilance, which is pretty nice. They're not quite enough mana to activate the Gix and have any cards left in hand. So let's just go Steel Seraph with Prototype. Give Adeline flying. And attack Oko, I think with just the Adeline. Because it's going to have 5 creatures at least. I mean, there's just, I think attacking for 2 points of damage with Selfless Spirit is just completely irrelevant. So I'd rather have another blocker. Because remember, Gix does trigger for every creature that hits me. They get to draw a card. So I'd like to have extra blockers back. And now they're presumably in a lot of trouble. Because I've got, I'm actually surprised that Cut Down hit the Esper Sentinel. The Giver of Runes feels like it's doing a lot more here. I guess they can discard one card and use Gix here. Discard a card to play my top card, but that doesn't seem like the strongest play in the world. And here, next turn, I'm going to get to... Well, it depends if I draw a land, I guess. Bitter Triumph, paying 3 life. Sure. I will give Steel Seraph Pro Black. Okay. I think I'm okay having Giver die. I have Selfless Spirit. Outland Liberator. Oh, they can kill or try to kill Steel Seraph. Well, this actually worked fine. I'll sack Selfless Spirit. So they're all indestructible. And then now they want to attack and get some cards. They'll lose Gix. So yeah, I guess they don't want to do that. All right, land would be pretty good. And in fact was. Let's go. I'm going to keep Wandering Emperor up. Let's give Adeline. I guess Adeline attacks for 3. Steel Seraph attacks for 3. But if I give Adeline flying, I mean, it's kind of the same thing. Because I don't want to attack on the ground, I don't think. And I'm happy enough just getting in for 3 and then passing. I'm going to play Wandering Emperor end of turn one way or another. They don't have enough mana to use the Gix, so I don't think I need to go minus Emperor minus 2 on Delighted Halfling. I do kind of have to think about it a little bit. Oh, Graveyard Glutton switched, flipped, but hopefully that prompts them to like make some sort of attack here. Okay. Gix is getting in? I didn't think so. Oh, they're all getting in. Okay. I think, let's see, What do I want to do here? Wandering Emperor. I mean, Wandering Emperor is going to be good here no matter what. I could just go kill the Gix. Well, I could block. Yeah, I mean, let's just see if Wandering Emperor resolves first, I guess. But and I suppose getting a Scrubland is even better. So, because I could make a creature to block with. They kind of should have attacked with these two dorks too, honestly. I think I really do want to get Gix off the board. So I can exile Gix and gain two, and then block and then take four. Or I can go make a token. I could also, wait, I could give Adeline first strike. Block. Yeah, that's probably even better. So I think I'll do, actually, I'll do Steel Seraph. I'll do like this. And then plus one in first strike on Steel Seraph. I feel like if they had anything, they would have cast it before blocks. Then I can first strike Gix away, and then now they hit me here for four, but they don't draw any cards. And then on my turn, I can Wandering Emperor, and I can like minus on something, or I can just give another plus, or I can put an idiot into play. Kind of whatever I want to do. Glimmerlens. Let's cast Glimmerlens. Make a token. Let's equip on Adeline. Let's wait on the... I think I'm going to... Actually, I guess... Yeah, discard a card. I could just discard a card to kill the Graveyard Glutton. That's probably fine. Oh, I guess I should have attacked first, but yeah. Yeah, that was a little bit sloppy. All right. I mean, kind of dominating here regardless. Adeline is going to get lifelink here. Because no longer needs to fly. And then I get to draw a card with Glimmerlens. Ooh, Samwise. Don't hate that. All right. And then I think we've basically gotten to the point where we can't really lose. I mean... Opponent would have to have something pretty good, because now it's like, even with a Wrath, I'm left with a Wandering Emperor and Smuggler's Copter with Lothari and Samwise in hand. If you don't have a Wrath, pretty much dead next turn. I'm drawing extra cards of Glimmerlens. Like, this has all come together nicely. Okay, up a game here. Playing against Sultai mid. I don't really want Relic Warder. This is the kind of matchup where Winds of Abandon can be good. You just kick it when the board stalls. Flip it and reverse it. What do I want to cut? I don't really want to cut anything because my deck is too good. Yeah, maybe it is too good. Maybe this is perfect. All right, game two on the draw. Well, I'm definitely keeping this hand. I'm just laughing because if I drew Novice Inspector, I could have turn one, double Novice Inspector. I think what I'm going to do probably is go... Well, it's tough. I kind of want to pitch Thraben Inspector to cast a turn one Stoneforge Mystic, but I guess I'm not getting anything too crazy. Oh, Samwise is nice too. I could also just go turn one Giver, turn two Stoneforge. That seems better. If I was getting Cauldra complete, that'd be a different story. But I think given where I'm at, it's fine just to slow play a little bit. And I'll probably still play this Chromox at some point, but I think I'll just wait a little here. All right. If I draw a medium spell this turn, then there's a decent chance. Oh, that's a completely different animal. I think I just say go now. Man, Orcish Bowmasters dunks on Jace and Fairy Mastermind so unbelievably hard. And I have Giver of Runes to protect it. If they don't Jace main phase, it's a little unfortunate, but I kind of feel like there's a chance they will. And either way, getting out the Orc seems pretty nice. Ophiomancer. Okay. I gotta just play the Bowmasters then, I think. Or I could wait. Killing the Jace. The Jace is already gonna... It's as good as dead. I have too much stuff to play. Oh, they just let it resolve? Well, I guess if I ping the Jace... Well, no, they should have still done it in response. Anyways, let's draw. They get a snake. Crack the Heath. I'm just debating whether or not I want to Samwise the... I think I do Samwise the land back. And the reason I want to do that is... I'm going to go get Skullclamp with the Stoneforge Mystic. And I think having more mana in play for that is going to be useful. I'll make Bowmasters the... Ring Bearer as well. I'm going to exile Thraben Inspector. Its time has come. So I can just Stoneforge here. I put a lot of stuff into play here. Oh, wait. They actually played around my Orc Army by making it so now it's going to be a 2-2 because of the Jace activation, so I don't get to Skullclamp it. Cycle Troll of Khazad-dûm. That is a good play. Troll is a very strong card. Oh, and they got Zagoth Triome. Okay. And presumably they're doing nothing here. Works for me. All right. more Thrabens where that came from. Let's Skull Clamp the Orc Army. If they want to play their Fairy Mastermind in response, they could get a card out of it, but I don't think that'll work out great for them. Skull Clamp the Samwise. Draw two cards. All right, well, that's a lot of lands, but I think that's still fine. Play Selfless Spirit, pass the turn. I'll draw enough cards that I can get through all these lands. All right, they're going to play their Fairy Mastermind. I can actually, like, kind of force them to trigger it by using Skullclamp. And then I get my Bowmaster trigger. That's pretty funny. Yawgmoth. Oh, geez. Okay. That is quite the card. I think in response, I'm supposed to give my Orc Pro black. Is that true? What does that do for me? They can't use it this turn, and they can use it on my upkeep, but that's still probably fine. Okay, give it pro black. All right, well, let's see what they're up to with this Yawgmoth. Yawgmoth? Oh, it means they can't sack the snake this turn. So they're not going to get a new one on upkeep. So at the very least, that's a good reason to do that. Turns out not drawing spells actually could come back to haunt me, but I think we're going to be okay still. I don't know. This is interesting. Oh, and I drew Lightning Bolt. Lightning Bolt's good. Let's go Novice Inspector. And I think I'm going to crack the clue because I actually don't mind the Fairy Mastermind triggering here because it'll make my Bowmasters trigger. Oh, I guess maybe I'm supposed to Skull Clamp there, actually. Giving it pro black. Yeah, no, I was supposed to Skull Clamp. That would have been better because then I could crack the clue in response. So they're putting a counter and then drawing a card. Okay, I guess that's fine. And then Bowmaster triggers, target Yawgmoth. And then I'll bolt the Yawgmoth. Okay, yeah, no, this worked okay. Yawgmoth did trade for the Bowmasters, but it was not the end of the world. Oh, they have... Oh, I should have sacked the... That didn't make any sense. All right, well, resolves, fails, and draw. Basically, I gave them an extra card, which I really didn't need to do. And then I will Skull Clamp the Orc Army, draw two more, and equip Skull Clamp on the stone. Or actually, I'm going to equip Skull Clamp on the. They're at 14. I'll equip it on the Novice Inspector so I can. Oh, I guess I can't even attack with that. Whatever. All right. not the ideal turn, but I think we're still in pretty good shape here. They get to Ophiomancer, but I have an Intrepid Adversary with a lot of lands in play. And I can start attacking with this Novice Inspector next turn. And also, drawing all these lands means at some point I'll draw a string of non-lands. They have their own Bowmasters. Okay. Yeah, all right. Draw two. Yeah, and then I'm going to get to, they're going to get to kill my Giver. Fair. And then I'm going to get to Skyclave the Orc Bowmasters. this has been quite the back and forth. If they have a counter for Skyclave, I could be in trouble. But remember, I also have like Otharian and Adeline and stuff like that in my deck. So I have some heavy hitters. Steel Seraph, Showdown of the Scalds even. And what is their last play? An Oko? What are they going to do? Make a food? Yep. I actually don't know that I want to kill the Bowmasters here. Let's see. Because I think just Skyclaving the Oko could be better. And just I have enough gas that I just don't use Skull Clamp. So I think I'm going to do that. Skyclave. Oko. And play Mother of Runes. And, of course, tap too many white, so I can't play Steel Seraph, but I'll do that next turn. I don't want to equip Skull Clamp, I don't think. I also don't really want to cycle Savai Triumph, so got to make sure not to do those things. 17. Yeah, I think... I also could hard cast Steel Seraph. That might also be good. They did have Outland Liberator for it, so I do have to keep that in mind. Next turn, I can play pretty big Intrepid Adversary if I want to. Attack me for three. They could even attack with the snake token if they want. All right, I'll take three. Go to 14. And Revoker. All right. I assume that's going to be on Mother of Runes. And then, yeah. And their last play, hopefully, is a Tenacious Underdog. Okay, that's not so bad. They have one card in hand? All right. Oh, Solitude. Okay, so 1, 2, 6. So I think what I might do here is prototype the Steel Seraph and try to bait them. Let's give Steel Skyclave flying, I guess. And what I mean by bait them is I can potentially, in response to them playing like a removal spell, I can go Solitude, Exile the Revoker, and then use Mother of Runes. So that actually sounds pretty good. They're going to draw a card. Oh, no, they're paying a life to gain three. Funny. Okay. I'm at 14. They can attack me for six this turn. I guess if they fire up the Tar Pit, that'll probably prompt action. Or if they show me what their last card in hand is. It would appear that they are playing their last card. Lorien Revealed. I'm actually going to do this in response because I am concerned about them drawing a counterspell. And I'm going to do this no matter what. So, and I think I'm just going to hit the Revoker to turn on Mother of Runes. They can draw their three, because then next turn I can slam Intrepid Adversary for 8 mana, give my whole squad +4/+4. I mean, that already is 14 damage in the air off Steel Seraph and Solitude. And then, actually, if they don't play a non-black creature, then I could potentially Mother of Runes the Skyclave past that too, though that's a little bit riskier. We'll have to see how that works out. All right, they're going to maybe attack me, but probably not, because I have a Mother of Runes up. And they already played their land, and I guess they don't have a play to make. I'm likely not going to go for the Mother of Runes. Oh, Hex Drinker. They could have cut down in hand still. Let's go Windswept Heath, Intrepid Adversary. And, oh, I guess if I want, I could Skull Clamp to get another attack in, another point in. I don't think I really want to do that, though. Let's give Solitude Flying. And attack, attack. And because of the snake token, I don't really want to attack with anything else. Take 12. Mm-hmm. All right, pass the turn. Sorry, this was +3/+3, not +4/+4. All right, well, they're at 4 now, facing down a pretty big board, and I'm back up to 20. Obviously, if they have a sweeper or something, that could be bad, but I've kept an Adeline in the chamber just in case. Maybe I was supposed to actually Skull Clamp something just in case they did have a sweeper. Yeah, I guess so. All right, Damnation it is. They're at 4, and I have an Othari in my deck. Don't mind. All right, let's... No real reason to crack the Windswept Teeth, I don't think, because there's a Yavimaya in play, so that's fine. Oh, well, that was a good draw. Let's go Palace Jailer here on your token. And then Adeline, and I guess equip the Adeline with Skull Clamp is probably going to be the play. Oh, actually, I guess I'm not gonna even equip the Adeline because I can just cycle Savai Triome. I think that's going to be a better use of my mana. All right, and then I have mana up if I need it. I don't have anything to attack with. I'm not going to play around the second sweeper. And remember, I still have Othari in my deck, so like that's already lethal in a lot of circumstances. I don't think I'm going to get decked here. They're probably going to sack that Peatland if they haven't... they don't have something to use it in their mana for. Oh, okay. And 7 mana, 3 cards in hand. I have a lot of lands in play. I just drawn so many cards off Skull Clamp. I drew a lot more than they did off the Yawgmoth. Though I guess they drew off Lorien Revealed and stuff too. I just have a lot of resources is what I'm saying. They do have a Creeping Tar Pit. They could take the Monarchy back, but I don't think that's really a winning play. Bitter Triumph, discarding Blood Chief's Thirst. Okay. Interesting. And then their last play is for 4 mana. 5 mana even. Hardcast Fallen Shinobi. Okay. I assume I'm going to win here unless I get pretty unlucky. Cycle Savai Triome. Glimmerlands isn't like the best. Oh, Showdown of the Scalds. Yeah, that'll probably do it. Mm-hmm. Othari is already lethal. Oh, Smuggler's Copter and all lands. Okay. Guess I'll play the copter, play a land, play Glimmer Lens. I have 6 cards in my deck. I don't really want to equip Clamp. I think I just pass the turn here. Draw end of turn with the Monarchy. Oh. Oh, 1 mana short of casting Wandering Emperor. That's okay. Crack the Peatland. I mean, again, if they want to attack with Creeping Tar Pit, they can. It's not really going to accomplish all that much. They'll take the Monarchy and they'll have 2 mana left to cast an instant. Let's just chump. Mostly I'm worried about them cloning the Palace Jailer, so I guess there's reanimate stuff too. I don't know. That's their last card. So they're dead. Okay, we got them. We got them, boys. We get to go. Showdown triggers. It kind of doesn't matter. Crew. And then equip Skull Clamp. They have no cards in hand. Equip Skull Clamp. And then I have a 4-point attacker. I went through my whole deck, but you know what? If that's what it takes. And then... Gonna hit them down to 0 here. The Dueling Bowmaster is very funny. I guess I will not loot. And, whew, what a match. Battle against Sultai. We are now 1-0 and on to round 2. Alrighty, up next here, we've got a nice little 1-2-3 curve with a Mutavault and all three of our colors. All right, works for me. Playing against a turn one Restless Bivouac. All right, play Figure of Destiny here. Pass the turn, and likely just running out turn two Intrepid Adversary. Yeah, I don't really see a reason not to, especially since, ooh, we got an Othari ready. That's going to be great in the red-white mirror. Flame Slash on the figure, and no plays. Okay, well, I guess I'll just attack. And I can't play my Skyclave, so let's just play some Itrium. I could play Mutavault, but I'd rather just play my Tapland and maybe give up a chance to attack with Mutavault, but in exchange, not have to worry about getting a Tapland into play. Sarah Paragon, but with no cards to bring back. All right, well, that's an easy Skyclaven. And Bash for another three. We even drew a Bowmaster, which is not bad. It's not like I expect my opponent to draw a bunch of extra cards, but Bowmaster is still just a really good card. Fury? Yeah, looks like. Okay. Well, if they kill Othari, that'll be pretty annoying. Otherwise, I kind of like where I'm at. Let's just play Othari. It just doesn't really make sense to wait. They get to eat the token, but then next turn I get to attack with two tokens, and I go to 29 here, and they go to 11. They didn't block the token? Well, that's weird. That's a pretty big error. I mean, they dismembered the Othari going down to 5, but they took an extra 2 damage and I have a 2-2 in play? Alright, feels like we're gonna be able to find a way to sneak in some extra damage here. Okay, I mean, I will take 10. This is a pretty big hit, but I have a Mutavault as well. And let's see, if they play a 1 toughness creature, that'd be nice. Oh, Glimmer Lens. Okay, I might be able to get them with Bowmasters. Oh, also, because they didn't block this, I can just bring Othari back. I mean, we'll take it. Okay, it's back. And pass, and they don't have lethal already. Let's see, 4, 8. I mean, they'd do 16 damage if I didn't have anything, but Bowmasters is going to be nice here. Put 2 blockers into play, and they're just going to attack with everything. I'm going to cast Bowmasters in response and ping the Rebel token. Then when they draw, ping it again. And then Bowmasters, well, the Orc Army token is going to chump the Fury, I think. I think I'd rather do that than take 6, especially since like so much of their win equity involves casting like a sweeper or killing Othari. And I don't mind losing the Orc Army here. I've got a Novice Inspector. I've got a Mutavault. So I have some good attackers. I mean, there is an argument for just taking 10. But, oh, it looks like we got there. Well, I would say they did not optimize against Othari there. Winds of Abandon, Arc Trail are both reasonable additions. I don't want Duress for sure. Esper Sentinel looks a little weak and gets just picked up by Fury kind of for free. So let's just put in a Winds of Abandon. And I think we're feeling pretty good. Maybe I'll put in the... Actually, maybe I should have put in the Timeless Dragon in this kind of matchup. All right, here... This isn't... drawing a land is pretty bad there. This isn't the best hand in the world. I'm kind of waiting... Because I might want to Chrome Mox the figure. But it'll kind of depend. Oh. Let's just play figure. And then if I draw any spell, I can play Palace Jailer into Othari. Cathar Commando. Do I want to block the Cathar Commando? I think so. When you have Palace Jailer in hand, I think it's generally good to trade off cards. All right. That's not ideal. Samwise got me good there. Ooh, Stoneforge Mystic. Okay. So I could Stoneforge. I think I'm just going to Palace Jailer into Othari here. Because I really want to cast Othari next turn. So and if I'm going to Mox, I might as well Mox and cast Make the Biggest Play now. Oh, I'm getting Mana Tithe. Okay. That's pretty good. I got to hand it to him. They have a Cathar Commando in hand, which They may or may not pop this Chrome Mox. My guess is they don't, yeah. All right, I'm going to try for Othari again. And hopefully they don't have Dismember. No, Swords to Plowshares even worse. Yeah, I mean, if they're going to be on three land and just kill every card I play, then I guess I'm probably going to lose. This looks like a game three situation shortly here. They traded for my figure, they mana tithe my Palace Jailer, they swords my Authority, and then that's pretty much all the spells I have. I think I'm pretty much out of spells. All right, Selfless Spirit. Sure, we'll play it. Why not? I could maybe block the Intrepid Adversary and take a bunch of damage. So I'd take 10 here. Or they... Yes, dog. Or they dismember and I take more. Okay. I go to 4. But I did get the adversary off the battlefield. And, oh, Novice Inspector. Don't call it a comeback. I mean, it's really not a comeback. But what if I draw... All right. If I drew a Bowmasters, I could get in there. Yeah, I do want Timeless Dragon, though, the way these games are going. And maybe I don't want Winds of Abandon, actually. I think Arc Trail would be better. I like Adeline. I like Steel Seraph. I like pretty much all the other cards. I even like... Selfless Spirit a lot. It's good against Fury. I might just take out Chrome Mox. And I put in the Dragon instead. All right. We'll try that. I'm on the play. Oh, yeah. Look at this hand. This hand is nice. So how do I want to play this hand? I think I'm just going to lead on turn 1 Mother of Runes. Yeah, that has to be right. And then turn 2, I go Arid Mesa, get probably... Well, it doesn't matter. One of the lands I can get with Arid Mesa, and then Samwise it back, and then I have all the mana I need. I have all my colors. If they don't kill the Mother of Runes, it blanks all their removal, which is nice. So they kind of have to lead with Swords to Plowshares or Dismember, and they mulligan. So I'm feeling pretty good about this game. It looks like, yeah, they're turn 1 dismembering Mother of Runes. That is a acceptable way to have things go down. I don't want to get mana tithed, so I'm just going to go get Badlands and then cast Samwise. Get back Arid Mesa. There's just no reason to get mana tithed here. I think that would be foolish. Thalia. Whew. Thalia is going to be tough. Well, I mean, this is going to be tough for them, is more what I mean. Because I'm going to... kill the Thalia for free with Bowmasters. They're already at 14 because of the Dismember. 12 now, and then I can maybe bolt this. Oh, yeah. Stop on your first main phase. Crack Arid Mesa, get Mountain. Bolt the Rabble Master. And this has just been play after play, just perfect. Oh, I was going to play and equip Glimmerlands, but no, Shonen of the Scald's even better. Oh, I did not mean to get... That was bad. I thought I was getting Scrubland. I guess I must have misclicked. Huh? Give my opponent a chance here. I don't think they're going to win still. I think we're going we're winning in a landslide. But if I played Shonen of the Scalds there, they assuredly wouldn't have won. But I suspect the most likely next action they take is conceding. But we'll see. Maybe they have something. Okay... just going to go to my attacks here. All right, attack with everything. Draw a card off Glimmerlands. We have a Cathar Commander, sure. They can block whatever they want. Block the 2/2 and go to 4. All right, well, play Showdown so I can't get mana tithed. Well, I guess they don't have mana tithe mana up. Anyway, and let's go... let's just play the Giver of Runes. It's fine if they have a Wrath. Next turn, I have a bunch more plays, a bunch of counters. They're just behind by so much. Even a Fury here wouldn't be that bad. Land, Fury, kill, Giver of Runes, Bowmasters, and Samwise. Yeah, I mean, that would be good, but then next turn, I would just put some counters. I would actually just win because I would go Shonen of the Scalds, put counters on and all that. All right, we're 2-0. Let's get to round three. All right, round three here. I'm on the play and fantastic hand. Two different one drops. I guess I'm probably not attacking with figure for a few turns. So let's just play the Novice Inspector. I think that's going to be better because there's a chance I might want to crack a clue at some point, though. Obviously, I'm going to play a turn two Smuggler's Copter. Well, maybe not. In fact, it's a lot less likely I play a turn two Smuggler's Copter now, but it's okay. I'll play either a turn two figure or turn two, maybe just crack the clue. I guess if I draw a land, I'm inclined to play figure. Oh, Skyclave down. All right. I guess they have something that they really want to keep safe from a Skyclave apparition. Interesting. Well, I'm going to hit and see where they're at. Okay, let's just crew with the Novice Inspector. I don't really need to play anything else yet. Maybe they have a way to kill Smuggler's Copter? No, they're letting me attack. All right, I'll loot. Yeah, I'll discard Steel Seraph. Okay, and let's crack the clue here. Land would be nice. No, all right. I mean, this is still fine. If they don't spend their mana here, then yeah. I'm kind of curious why they took the Skyclave Apparition, especially when I was on a two-lander. Narset? Okay, that's all right, too. Let's go Figure of Destiny. Crew Narset. Or crew Smuggler's Copter, rather. And let's attack Narset. Those two. Oh, I didn't even get the option of drawing a card. And then now I could play Skullclamp, or I can leave up Bolt. I think I'm just going to pass, because I'm kind of worried that they're going to time Twister with Narset in play. And if they do that, oh. I wanted to be able to bolt the thing. All right. Yeah, let's just bolt Narset now. It's fine. I just wanted to use my mana. And now I think I am going to Solitude here. Let's crew the copter first with figure. I think I'm actually going to pay some life here. So I'm going to crack the Windswept Heath. I'll just get a Plains. I'm going to play Skullclamp, and, oh, actually, do I want to clamp? Because I have a play here where I can go pitch cast Solitude on Shieldred, and then get it, use Samwise to get the Solitude back. That's probably pretty good, in which case I don't want to equip Skullclamp here. Alternately, I can equip Clamp and then try, hope to draw something, but let's just do this. I think Solitude's good enough that I'd rather just keep the Solitude if I can. Hopefully I don't have Force of Will. Okay, they appear not to. And Solitude goes away. Shieldred goes away. Let's play Samwise. Maybe they have Days and that's what they've been waiting on. Days for Days. And they do. Ha. All right. You know what? I think we're doing just fine. I don't think I want to loot. Doesn't really seem like it does much for me. So they're at 16, have 5 cards in hand. One's an island. I have a couple things in play, and this clamp's about to potentially go big. Grief with no targets. Okay. Like, I have no cards in hand? I don't mind that at all. Bowmasters? Are you kidding me? Oh, that's unbelievable. So let's go crew. And I'm going to give up a loot here, but in exchange, Grief is probably going to block the Novice Inspector here. I'd be a little surprised if they didn't. Okay. And then I get to go Orcish Bowmasters to finish off the grief. And then I get to clamp the token. Yeah, Orcish Bowmasters is pretty good in this deck. Not going to lie. All right, I'll play my Savai Triumph and pass the turn. This looks great. Feel like we're pretty much doing it. All right, and pass here. I mean, Skullclamp is just giving us the extra gas that we really need here. So let's go Glimmer Lens. And it'll kind of depend if this resolves. I think what I'm going to do is Crew the Copter. And then I want to move the Glimmer Lens to the figure. And I guess I don't really need to pump the figure here, so let's just go attack like this, and maybe I'll loot away this land. And, all right, I get to attack, so and then I get to stack the triggers. I want the Glimmer Lens to resolve first so I can draw a card, and then loot. And discard Arid Mesa. All right, they're just not doing anything. I'll play Mutavault and I'll equip Skullclamp on my Rebel token, I guess, in case they play a Sweeper or something. They've played some good cards. Shieldred, Daze, Narset, Inquisition, Grief. These are all fine cards, but they have spent the last two turns. We're not really doing anything, and every turn I'm adding lands to the pile. Cycling us Xander's Launch. Yeah, that's what you'd call a bit of desperation, I would say. Well, looks like we're going to be up a game here, which is pretty good for a deck that we really only started drafting at the latter half of pack one. That was just wild. Okay, let's just play our stuff. It's fine. Adeline. I mean, I don't see a reason not to attack with, just send everything in. No reason to let World's Pine Worm flash or some nonsense like that get us. I'm going to put Duress in. Duress seems like it's a good card against this deck. What do I want to take out? Steel Seraph isn't really great. You don't care about the combat abilities that much. And I'm not to the point where I want Winds of Abandon or Seasoned Hallowblade. I think this looks good. All right, on the draw. Oh, the double Inspector draw. I'm going to keep this. And if I draw a Chrome Mox, I'm going to play two Inspectors on turn one. Maybe. Is Skyclave going to get taken out? Oh, Skyclave was taken to protect Shieldred. You know, I still don't really agree with that, given the fact that I had a two-lander and Smuggler's Copter got to attack a bunch of times, but hey, you know. All right, there goes Giver. What am I hoping for here? I don't really want to draw Chrome Mox, but it would be funny if I did. Touch the Spirit Realm is decent because I might be able to pitch cast Solitude and touch the Spirit Realm. The only thing about that, of course, is that not playing against a deck that's going to have a bunch of creatures in play. So Touch the Spirit Realm, Solitude, it works best when they have two creatures because you go Solitude, Exile, you know, get one of your creatures, Touch the Spirit Realm, it comes back, get your other creature, all that. But all right, they're just chilling. I was just going to crack this clue, but Esper Sentinel is a pretty nice one. So let's just go Esper Sentinel and play another Novice Inspector. And can start cracking clues next turn. That seems fine to me. Ship the turn. They want to kill my Esper Sentinel and give me a card. I'll take it. If they want to, I mean, Toxic Deluge would be kind of annoying, but I would actually be up a card because all these replace themselves. Let's see what they've got. And then I have Solitude and Touch the Spirit Realm to take care of some amount of resistance from the opponent. In fact, I have three removal spells in hand. Oh, they didn't play a land. I drew a land. All right. Let's hit. And you know what? I'm actually fine just not cracking the clue here. I feel like the odds of drawing a one mana spell seem less relevant than the likelihood that I'll want to use like Touch the Spirit Realm or something along those lines, or if they have like another hand disruption spell. I don't really want them getting more different cards to take So now, if they play, like, Hole Breacher, I guess, is the card I would be concerned with. But because of the Solitude, I'm kind of protected from that. So, presumably they're going to play something. Grief Evoking Pitching Snuff Out. All right. You can take my Solitude, I guess. I don't think Evoking Solitude to kill the Grief there is a very good play. And I guess I'm glad I didn't crack the clue, because now they don't know what the card is that I'm drawing off that, nor do they get a chance to take it. Now it's funny, the clues from the different eras. Yeah, they took the Solitude, but then they didn't play anything else. Okay. Crack a clue. If we get Hole Breachered, we get Hole Breachered. Draw, and... yeah, I'll Intrepid Adversary here. Why not? One of the things I like about Intrepid Adversary as well is it makes the Esper Sentinel a 2-2, which makes it even harder for them to avoid giving me a card when they do want to play a spell. They could daze it to prevent me from paying the mana, but they are not doing that. All right. So now I get to hit for 6 here. And if they want to kill the Intrepid Adversary, I probably get a card off Esper Sentinel, which is nice. Petty Theft, bouncing the Intrepid Adversary. Yep. They can't, in fact, pay 2. So now, I mean, they didn't even kill my thing. That was such a good exchange. Like, I drew a card and they bounced my thing. Yeah, I've got some good value creatures here. Shieldred, oh, Damnation, and I get another card. I'm up cards on this exchange. My 3 creatures drew me 4 cards, or drew me 2 cards, drew me 4 cards total, so. I don't actually have, like, an amazing play here. I could just play Palace Jailer. The only thing that I don't like about that is they have this Brazen Borrower, but I think it's worth it. All my other, like, I have all these other removal spells in hand. It just doesn't really make sense. All right. Palace Jailer, ship the turn, draw a card. I mean, they're really far away from Brazen Borrowing to take back the Monarchy. And I can also touch the Spirit Realm on my Palace Jailer, which is a pretty nice little combo. Okay. Let's just get Savai Triumph. I'm not going to be cycling Savai Triumph this game, I don't think. Let's play Intrepid Adversary. And I'm just going to pay 1 here. Let's go like this. Because this way I can leave the clue up, plus touch the Spirit Realm up. And those both seem pretty good to have. Plus, I still have lethal next turn, actually. Mutavault plus Palace Jailer plus Adversary is the full 10. I get a card end of turn. Oh, Wandering Emperor's another good one. This game's getting out of reach. And this is part of the reason White Weenie's so good. Like, my opponents had kind of a bad draw. They haven't really done that much. But, I don't know, they cast Damnation, Grief, they had a Snuff Out, they had Brazen Borrower. Just, the White Weenie cards just generate value every single turn. And now you end up in a spot where it's like, they can kill all my stuff and I still have just like a handful of cards. Like, I'm out controlling them. And this is 10, so they have to have something. I can remove a blocker with any variety of cards, and I have a Lightning Bolt, so yeah, you got a Brazen Borrower. I agree with that. Let's go ahead and finish this game off, and that will give us a nice little cube trophy rewarded for switching. And if you take anything out of this draft, it's that switching can pay off. So thanks for watching. As always, this draft was brought to you by Ultimate Guard, sponsor of Team CFP, and of course, TCG Player. You can get anything you need card-related over at tcgplayer.com. Plus, check out Channel Fireball. All articles are free now. No more paywall. So, everything is free, and Channel Fireball still has all the best content on the internet. Thanks for watching. See you next time.